All right, we're going to talk about Pi Manual Logger Scheduling. Scheduling is a feature of tours that dictates when tour runs should be taken. Let's look at a tour definition. I'm going to go to an existing tour reactor. It's been previously configured. It has all of the tags that need to be there. It has groups, and of course I've set the order in which I want to take the readings on the tags. And security's been set. But the tour was not set up with scheduling originally. Let's see, this is blank. Another note on scheduling. We note here it's available for the tour on that global basis, but even on an individual tag, I can set scheduling. The same is true for a group. There's a priority or precedence of these. So if I'm looking at tag configuration, it's going to supersede all other types of scheduling. So if I choose one of my tags here and I set scheduling for it, it will override the group scheduling and the tour scheduling. The same is for group. I'm moving up the chain. If there's group scheduling, it will override the tour scheduling. Okay, let's first start with the tour scheduling. Tour scheduling hasn't been configured, so I'll do that now. I'll click on the set button, and I see I have a simple on-off for clock scheduling. I'm going to turn that on. Next, I have an additional set button. This brings up a dialog that lets me configure the times involved. First, we'll focus on recurrence pattern. This is how often the data is collected. If I choose hourly, it defaults to every 1 hour. But I see I have a spinner button that lets me increase this to any time I'd like. That's a whole number factor of hours. The same is true for the other recurrence patterns. Daily, I choose this. It defaults to 1 day, but I can bump this. The one recurrence pattern that's a little unique is weekly. Here, I still have the factor of how many or how often the data should be collected. So in this case, I'm saying every 4 weeks. But I can also choose weekdays that the data should be collected. So in this case, it's Sundays, Mondays, and Tuesdays every 4 weeks. For now, let's start with a simple pattern of every 4 hours. Looking at the schedule time at the top, I have a date, a start date. Generally, I'd leave this at the current date, but I'm going to backdate this. And I'm doing this just because it's going to help me illustrate more clearly the scheduling. We'll see this when I actually do tour runs. Below, we see we have a start time and end time. With these clock times, I'm accomplishing two things. One, I'm setting a window during which the data should be collected. If you notice in this case, I'm just setting the window very small, 1 second. So I'm saying I want the data at the 3 o'clock time. The second thing I'm doing is setting the time on the clock when I want the data to be collected. So what this means is, with this combination here, is with 3 p.m., I want the data to be collected starting at 3 p.m. and then every 4 hours afterward. So 3 p.m., 7 p.m., 11 p.m., etc. If I had set this to some odd time, say 3:37 p.m., then my data would be due at 3:37 p.m., and then 7:37 p.m., etc. For now, let's keep this straightforward configuration, 3 p.m. every 4 hours. Let's say OK, OK here as well. Now I see that I have tour scheduling. As you might recall, I'd said that we can do scheduling actually on a group here, or a tag also. I'm going to choose a tag. Go and add scheduling here. The scheduling dialogues and choices are exactly the same for tours, groups, and tags. So I'm going to turn on clock scheduling. I'll do my set, my recurrence. I'm going to choose hourly. I'm going to bump this to 8 hours. Because in my example here, this particular tag I'm working with is only due every 8 hours, as opposed to the 4 hour scheduling that I have set for the tour. Again, I'm going to set my times here. And now I'm done. So now what I have as far as my configuration is a tour that is due every 4 hours, and one of the tags within the tour is only due every 8 hours. So I'll do a save at this point. One thing to note before I leave the configuration area. Down here there's an icon with a drop down. One of the menu options is schedule overview. If I bring this up, expand this a little, I can see all of the scheduling for my tour. So I have some tour scheduling, and also have scheduling on an individual tag. If I had many schedules distributed through here with groups and tags, I may want to look at this overview. It gives me a really good look without having to navigate through each of these entities. Okay, I'm going to leave tour definition now. I now will create a new tour run based on my updated tour definition. So I'll choose manual data entry, my tour reactor, and then double clicking begins a new tour run. The first thing to note is the 7 p.m. start time. My current clock time is 4:04 p.m. If you recall, the tour scheduling configuration had the start time at 3 p.m. to recur every 4 hours. Since it's past 3 p.m., the next due tour time is 7 p.m. If I use the drop-down, I'll see past due times. We see that this is every 4 hours, just as my recurrence pattern is set. This is why I backdated the original start time, so that we could see these. There are options to override this time. The plus and minus buttons allow me to subtract or add an hour. The now button, I can use the current time. Calendar button, set the date, or I can manually type over the time. In almost all cases, I would just take the time that came from the scheduling. So, I'm satisfied with this time. I say OK. Now I'm here with standard manual logger data entry. Again, my tour timestamp can be overwritten with this button using current time. My tour timestamp is inherited by all of the tags on the tour. They also have the ability to be set individually, current timestamp, overwritten, as I go through each tag. If I look at my tree view, I have some icons next to the tags listed here. The question mark indicates that no value has been entered for this tag on this tour run. The X mark indicates that no value is due. If you recall, this is the tag that we set up the 8-hour frequency for. So, with his 8-hour frequency and a begin time of 3 p.m., he is not due until 11 p.m. So with this 7 p.m. tour, he's not needed to be entered. If I begin my data entry just as I normally would, I'll enter a value, hit return, enter my next value, hit return. Now let's see what happened. I just entered reactor temperature, and then it navigated to reactor valve out 2. It skipped the reactor capacity because it knows that it was not a due tag. So I can complete my tour. And now I'm done. I have all of the data values that were required, along with this data is not required. I'm going to do a save now. I'll say save. And I'll exit my tour. So now I've successfully used a tour run that had scheduling. It had both tour scheduling and tag scheduling.